Over the last few years, the Friends of Streatham Hill Theatre have made amazing progress, campaigning to save and restore this lavish Grade 2 listed Sleeping Beauty for the people of Streatham and South London. With the smell of fresh paint and a grand staircase completed only hours earlier, the theatre opened on the 20th of November 1929, boasting an auditorium that seated over 2,800 and a stage equivalent in size to a large West End theatre. It was the last project by the renowned theatre architect and South London resident W.G.R. Sprague. Performances continued throughout the war years, until a direct hit by a V1 doodlebug on the 3rd of July 1944. After a post-war hiatus, the damaged auditorium and stagehouse were rebuilt. On Christmas Eve 1950, it reopened for the pantomime Cinderella and continued to entertain audiences for another 12 years. However, competing against the increasing ownership of television sets, audience numbers waned. And on the 14th of November 1962, the theatre became a bingo hall, calling house right through until that also closed in 2017. Nevertheless, there's no doubt that bingo helped it dodge the developer's wrecking ball. With the theatre's future once again uncertain, a group of local residents formed the Friends of Streatham Hill Theatre to promote the protection of the building and return it to community use. Since 2018, the building has been on the Theatres Trust's Theatres at Risk register. The urgency of our campaign is due to two things. Firstly, the knowledge that the owners had investigated whether they could redevelop parts of the building as flats. And secondly, that with only the casino slot machine lounge behind the foyer currently in use, the rest of the building could be decaying away. We do know the basement, for example, has been prone to flooding. In 2018, we organised a flash mob of over 1,000 members of the public, which helped us successfully fight an appeal by the owners of the building to overturn Lambeth's listing of the theatre as an asset of community value. And this was picked up by BBC London TV News. In 2019, on the 90th birthday of the theatre, Simon Callow, who was born in Streatham, and long-time Streatham resident Catherine Russell cut a cake to launch our crowdfund campaign for a viability study and economic impact assessment as the first step in securing the future of the theatre. Against all the odds, in 2020, we successfully overcame the restrictions of the pandemic, passing our crowdfund target and raising £46,000. We say against all the odds because the fact that we gained public donations and grants from Lambeth, the GLA and the Theatres Trust when we don't own, lease or even have access to the building is quite astounding. Grants aren't normally awarded in cases like this. The contract for the studies was awarded to FEI and we look forward to the delivery of their report early in 2021. The campaign's success demonstrates strong and growing support in the community and recognition by the authorities that the theatre's future is in jeopardy and it needs to be saved. Here are some examples of the support we've been receiving. Lambeth Council's Streatham Investment and Growth Strategy for the coming decade recognises the need to get the theatre back into use, restoring it as a community hub for entertainment and culture and helping regenerate the Streatham Hill section of the High Road. We say restore because in years gone by, Streatham was the South London entertainment destination with four or five cinemas, the Locarno Ballroom and Nightclub, where many major international musicians and bands performed, and the Streatham Hill Theatre. Oscar winners Jessica Tandy, Sean Connery and Michael Caine are among the list of famous stars that performed at the theatre in plays, variety, musicals, opera and ballets. International stars like Paul Robeson Anna Pavlova and Margot Fonteyn also played there. Alongside Wimbledon and Richmond theatres, it was part of a South London circuit that took pre- and post-West End shows and tours. When built, Streatham Hill Theatre was easily accessible via train and bus. Today, with fast, direct routes to Clapham Junction, London Victoria, Brixton and Croydon, it's well situated to sustainably serve South London and the commuter belt. Additionally, a large, vibrant and diverse community of people live within practical walking and cycling distance. The area around the theatre is home to a variety of independent shops, bars and restaurants, many of which recognise the benefit that an active theatre would bring and have generously supported the campaign. A creative ecosystem is evolving around the theatre, with projects like the annual Streatham Festival, as well as the Hideaway Jazz Club, and the Streatham Space Project, a smaller studio-sized theatre that's supportive of our campaign. However, the area clearly needs regeneration, and building on its existing strengths and the calibre of companies and artists already performing in Streatham, our creative vision would see the theatre as an integral part of getting Streatham back on the map as an entertainment hub for South London. Here's our architect's sketch of the huge part it could play in the community. For example, brightening up and making the high road more welcoming by giving a focus to the various cultural and leisure activities. Amit Panesar, our lead architect, guided by a panel of experts and taking input from local creatives and the community itself, created the Friends' initial vision for the future of the building. This is how the theatre currently looks from the outside. The heavy-handed hoardings make it drab and uninviting on a high street that has suffered along with many others in the country. And this is how we envisage it, inviting to visit and exciting to enter. Parts of the front that are currently boarded up could be opened up for concessions, such as a bookshop and cafe. The cafe culture on the parade of nearby shops could be extended at times down to the front of the theatre, as shown at the bottom left. The balcony could be enjoyed by patrons. And the roof could house a terrace bar or restaurant. Away from the front facade, a bird's eye view shows the scale of the theatre. From the back, we can see the building offers many possibilities, especially at the rear and side. This area above the boiler house could be extended, and space above the dressing room block offers similar possibilities. Up on the roof, there's the potential for a terrace bar or restaurant overlooking the high road, whilst it might also be viable to build a rooftop studio space full of natural light. And of course, there's enough space up there for capturing solar energy. Looking inside the building, these pictures, taken in 2018, show the magnificent, inviting foyer. And the stalls and huge stage area. Unfortunately, we haven't any clear photos of the stage itself, but it's of a similar area to that of the London Palladium, with an equivalent size of proscenium opening. You can see the stall seating has been removed to house the bingo tables. And here's the current layout of the circle and dress circle with their first-class sight lines. There's a unique, large stage house intact with all the original equipment. These pictures are of the stage machinery, the flying gear, and the machinery for the orchestra lift. Our vision is for it to be a hub of activity, delivering broad benefits to the local area, where there's always something on, and not just on the stage or stages, from platform performances to art shows, rehearsals, and workspaces. By keeping the auditorium's existing flat floor, it could be used for exhibitions, markets, or even weddings. The theatre should be an open community space, supporting the next generation of local creative talent and providing social engagement activities for people of all ages and backgrounds. At the moment, there's nowhere in Streatham or the surrounding area of a large enough size for performances for the many local creative organisations. In looking at the future of the theatre, we'll need to consider what can be done in the short term and what can be done in the long term. Even in its existing condition, it could be brought back into use to deliver this vision quickly, at relatively small cost, and in a short time scale. Longer term, we can develop a programme for further restoration and regeneration. Now looking at a long-term vision for the future interior of the theatre. This section focuses on the stage, auditorium and front-of-house areas and doesn't go into detail about all the numerous spaces in the building which Armeet Panesar and our chair David Harvey have collated. They know every inch of the theatre. On the left, you can see the entrance from the high road and the foyer, with a basement room below and rooms above, which could be used for bars, food concessions, meeting rooms and workshop or studio performance spaces. Moving on to the theatre space itself, we've looked at making it flexible, retaining as much of the original as possible. The existing 2,800 seats could be retained for large-scale performances, or the back walls could be moved forwards to create a potentially more viable 1,500 to 1,800-seat theatre, leaving the raked space behind the circle and dress circle for cinemas or lecture theatres. There's the potential for a removable clear cube theatre space of around 500 seats. The audience would walk into it, being able to see the splendour of the original theatre through its walls, only to find themselves, when the lights dim, in an acoustically sound, intimate performance space. The roof area could house that terrace bar or restaurant, or even the studio previously mentioned. The safety curtain can be lowered when required, and with some acoustic treatment, the stage itself could be used as a large rehearsal space, which could prove a good revenue stream due to the current dearth of these. It could also be used as, say, a 200-seat theatre space, or for large commercial or social events. There are basement areas that could be used for rehearsal space, storage, or even a pop-up atmospheric bar. Finally, at the back of the theatre, behind the stage, there are five stories in the dressing room block. Some of these could be used as business workplaces or studios. So that's our creative vision for the theatre. And now we need to realise it. We obviously have to factor in the outcome of the viability study and economic impact assessment. We based our vision on the idea that a 2,800-seat theatre here in Streatham was unlikely to be viable. We're now learning that there is interest out there by operators for theatres of this size, but only if the significant capital and refurbishment costs for full restoration are met by others. Therefore, there are more options open to us than we initially thought. In these challenging times for public funding, this means we may need to consider if a more phased approach to reopening might be best. Separately, we've had an initial meeting with Lambeth Planning to find out what applications might get through if we had use of the building, including possible changes and improvements, and those discussions are ongoing. A word about COVID. Many venues have suffered during this pandemic, but we feel that's partly due to them literally only housing a theatre and, say, a bar and restaurant. We believe our building would be more resilient, with a better chance of renewal and surviving any future pandemic or downturn, as its array of workable spaces provide so many opportunities. On the 20th of November 2020, to celebrate the theatre's 91st birthday, the Friends were thrilled to announce the names of 9 highly respected patrons, representing between them a wide range of disciplines within the industry. At the same time, we also announced the launch of an ongoing list of over 100 individual creative industry supporters, placed alongside our growing list of supporting companies and organisations, all giving their strong backing to our campaign. On the 28th of January 2021, the Theatres Trust published its 2021 Theatres at Risk Register, once again featuring the Streatham Hill Theatre. And the Friends released a crucial statement of historical significance for the theatre. On the same day, the Friends were delighted to announce Akram Khan as their 10th patron. We look forward to being able to announce further patrons in the future. So, watch this space. Our next steps are to take on board the findings of the viability study for a sustainable future, to continue campaigning for awareness of the case for a future, to continue pressing for action to deliver that future, and to build a good relationship with the theatre's owners and leaseholders going forward. We'd love you to join us. To support the Friends campaign, you can visit the website, sign up to the newsletters, spread the word, join the fortnightly campaign meetings, volunteer your time, help fundraise, and donate. Thank you for your time.